this is a complication of GERD. Okay, and gastroesophageal reflux disease. Okay, so if we have a Barrett esophagus, it means that we have a metaplastic event. There's a metaplasia occurring. The normal landing of the esophagus is stratified wings. Okay, in cases of gastroesophageal reflux, there would be a metaplasia occurring, replacing the squamous with intestinal glands. Okay, so tawag doon is Barrett esophagus. Why is it significant? Because it's the only way that an adenocarcinoma would be presented in the esophagus. Okay? So it's the most significant risk factor for development of adenocarcinoma in the esophagus. Okay? Because most common malignant tumor in the esophagus is coming from its native lining epithelium, which is a squamous cell. Okay? But for it to have an adenocarcinoma, it should present first with the Barrett esophagus. So, yeah, the typical timing, okay, malignant metastasis cells, forming back-to-back glands. Two treatments. Squamous cell carcinoma of the esophagus. So this is the most common. This is associated with, again, with smoking.
Yes.
Alcoholism. So you have breast or metastasis squamous cells. Wow, this is a keratin curd. So we go to your favorite skin fibrosarcoma, ano yung typical pattern niya? Meron kayo dyan? The herringbone pattern. Okay, herringbone pattern. H-E-R-R-I-N-G. Herringbone. Because, I think the author is an American. So, they had herringbone. If it's, if the author was from the Philippines, it's a big fish. So, any bone, like a fish bone, it's a deformation. Based on architectural pattern. This is the slide. Yeah. the gastric lymphoma, you see that the pattern for the cells is diffuse. Okay? It's diffuse. No lymphoid follicles. This is the other type. Okay? You have the follicular lymphoma. So this is the follicular. And you will get to know them better after my lectures on cardiovascular lymphoma. There are lots of things. Okay, so in gastric lymphoma, the culprit, they would say, is the presence of H. pylori. It can cause lymphoma in the stomach.
So,
the stomach line.